An accused drug dealer facing murder charges will stay in jail.
Police say he gave several people a designer drug called 2CE. One person was killed, sent several others to the hospital. A friend called 911 when they got sick.
What's wrong with the other person?
The same thing they took some kind of drug.
Now, according to court papers, Cody Weddle bought 2CE powder online, then mixed it in the water and sold it. Eyewitness News' Carla Wade was in court as he faced a judge. Carla?
That's right. Weddle remains here in the Pontotoc County Jail. He possibly faces first-degree murder charges in the death of 20-year-old Stacy Jewell. Now, Weddle told police exactly where he got those drugs from, and for that reason, Jewell's mother is outraged.
This garbage comes up on the computer, and sometimes these kids just do not want to take heed.
And because police say 20-year-old Cody Weddle did not heed warnings about the dangerous drug found on this website, grieving mother Linda Beckman says he deserves to pay. Her daughter, Stacy Jewell, died after overdosing on 2CE, a form of ecstasy. Weddle will remain in the Pontotoc County Jail for a while after a judge refused to grant him bail. According to an arrest affidavit, Weddle admitted to buying the drug 2CE on the internet. This is the website chemicology.net, where police say Weddle placed an order on April 26th. Weddle told police that he bought 1 gram of 2CE for $120. When he received it, he, along with Stacy Jewell and a person identified as Andrew Ackerman, diluted it into 1 liter of water. The plan was to sell 15 milliliters of the substance for $15. That 15 milliliters was supposed to be diluted in 20 ounces of water. But the DA says that's not what happened once it got to this rural Seminole County home. After drinking the undiluted drug, 8 people overdosed with deadly consequences. Beckman says she understands several families are hurting right now, including Weddle's, but she can't get past her anger.
I do understand that they're going through pain, but at least they'll be able to see their kids. Mine's underground, and something better be done. That's all I can say.
And we spoke with the DA this afternoon. He tells me they are still investigating and that there's the possibility there may be other arrests to come from this case. We also talked to the parent of 2 people that were released from the hospital yesterday. We'll hear from them coming up at 6. Reporting live, Carla Wade, Eyewitness News 5.
Okay, Carla, we'll see you then. 5 victims are still in the hospital, and we're told at least one is still in very critical condition.